November 15th, day 61 of the NHL lockout, 2 months into this frustrating dispute, and the optimism of last week has crumbled into the realization this battle has a long, long way to go. It's being reported Gary Bettman has suggested the two sides take a break from negotiations, a break of up to 2 weeks. He is reportedly still awaiting a response from Donald Fehr and the Players Association. If that is indeed the case, there's no way we're going to see NHL hockey until mid-December, if at all. NHL Deputy Commish Bill Daly told Hockey Central, Don Fehr called Gary Bettman and suggested he didn't know how to proceed from here. Gary suggested that perhaps a moratorium might be in order. We haven't heard back from him. The words again of Bill Daly. NHLPA Special Counsel Steve Fehr responded with, and, you know, is it just me or... would you rather see highlights as opposed to these quotes? Maybe one day. The players have offered the owners concessions worth about $1 billion. What exactly have the owners offered the players? If indeed they do not want to meet, it will be at least the third time in the last 3 months that they've shut down the dialogue, saying they will not meet unless the players meet their preconditions. What does that tell you about their interest in resolving this? With more, Jeff Merrick and his Hockey Central panel.
Alongside Brad May and Doug McLean. So what are you guys doing for the next couple of weeks? Because it seems as if the National Hockey League and the Players Association won't be doing much. Gary Bettman proposing a 2 weeks hiatus on CBA negotiations, to which Doug McLean says...
are you kidding me? No, seriously. So Gary proposes a 2 week hiatus for what reason? Well, it's two more paychecks for the players and the pressure mounts. Good ploy by him. There's not a snowball's chance the players are going to accept that. They're prepared to meet at any time. So Steve Fehr comes back with his comments. But for Gary to say we'll take 2 week break, I mean, you take two week breaks, Gary, if it's in the summer. You don't do it now when the season is shut down and you're in a lockout. That's for off-season negotiations. What you do this time is you get in and you negotiate in good faith and you try to hammer out a deal. This is bizarre. But the whole thing has been bizarre, so why would we expect anything more from both sides?
From a fan's point of view, the optics of this do not look good. What about from a player's point of view? Let's say you're back in the NHL right now, Brad May, and you just hear this piece of news.
Just Gary scored Bettman 50 saying, goals. Make on, you got 50.
Wow.
Hart Trophy candidate, just won the Rocket Richard Trophy.
Oh, no, you were
well.
A good junior.
you had some
you're
nights.
A great junior and a real good NHLer.
Hey, is this what it's come to, guys, in the lockout?
We remember that goal against the Boston Bruins. Don't worry, buddy. You swept them in four. Now, if you're a player and you hear this news, what goes through your mind? What do you think?
Well, the first thing is to suggest that you're not going to meet for 2 weeks, it's to put pressure on the players, to make the players bleed a little bit more. As Doug said, miss the paychecks. You know, they missed one yesterday, possibly, and then another 2 weeks. 2 weeks of training camp. It's a month before hockey's going to be played. This is to put pressure on the players. But the Players Association didn't buy that. The other thing, I got to make another point. This is brutal for the fans. This is unfair to the fans of hockey, the people that stay up at night watching us talk about hockey and watch games and want to cheer on their local heroes, the players that they look up to. This is just brutal.
But we have to keep in mind, if the players stay out all year, they lose $2 billion in salaries. If the NHL shuts down, it's a $3+ billion business. There's too much at stake for these two sides not to get into a bargaining room and work this out. And I'm telling you, we will play because there's too much at stake for either side to blow this.
No one believes we actually got to the place we are right now. It's kind of like saying, well,
crazy.
Why are you banging your head against the wall?
You were
well, because
player.
It feels good when I stop.